Coach Bailiff, welcome.
How you doing?
Listen, I'll be the first to say it. College football is always better with David Bailiff in it. Am I right? Listen, well, I mean, I was a little pup covering him at Rice. I was like the scared, you probably don't remember me, but welcome back to.
Great to be here. I'm working at a great university.
You are, and you're filling some pretty big shoes.
Colby. Yeah, Colby did a great job. I called him right when I got this job, and I said, couldn't you just won 9 one year? I mean, you had to win 10 3 years in a row. Expectations are high, and I look forward to it. We have a great president, have a great athletic director. Got some fantastic young men on this football team, and I'm blessed to be the head coach there. Absolutely love it. 61 years old, but when you get to hang out with 18 to 22, I thought I was 24. They finally said, Coach, you know you got gray hair and you got to slow down a little bit. But I do. When you love what you do, you don't get old. I can't imagine doing anything else. You know, you do. You love it. You get out of bed every morning. Can't wait to go to work. I didn't bring the most talented. I brought the most handsome. We had a poll of who are the two best-looking guys on the team. And so they wanted offensively and defensively. Best hair. Volumizing shampoo.
Oh.
Really helps.
We'll have to trade secrets a little later.
Really helps.
Listen, I want you to introduce them. Who are these two gentlemen?
This is Dominique Ramsey. He is an All-American punt returner, an All-Conference free safety. Plays football at 1,000,000 miles an hour, one of the hardest workers I've ever been around. Amon Simon is a first-team All-Conference. Left tackle is a sophomore, so they're both juniors. So not only are they handsome, they both really are pretty good football players, too. So their poster, I mean, if you ask for volunteers, their hands go up. You know, anything you need, these two are ready to go, and I admire them for that. And we have a bunch of guys on the team that are just like them. Colby really left us with a good culture. You know, there's a good blueprint there, and it's the first job I've ever had, you know, that's winning. And so it's unique. The ones I'd taken over before were rebuilding. This is one where we just have to sustain, and somehow the expectation is to compete for conference championships, national championships, and that's what the city expects, that's what the university expects, that's what these young men expect. And you know what? The coaches in this room, I've known a lot of them for a long time. There is more parity in this conference, I think, than people realize, especially listening that four-year starters. You know, I think it's going to be an unbelievable competitive year in the Lone Star Conference. And really, a couple of these guys, we go back where we were dashingly handsome and young, thought we were pretty good looking. And so I've known some of them 20, 30 years. And you know, they're great coaches. And you sit in the room with these other coaches that I'm getting to know, wonderful coaches in this league. And Jay's done a big-time job of growing this Lone Star Conference. And, you know, it gets more exciting. You know, every time there's a news release, it's more exciting.
Yeah, you're an LSC guy.
I played in the Lone Star Conference. Yeah.
How have you seen it evolve?
Say that again.
How have you seen this conference evolve since those playing days?
I was going bald.
You two have some nice lettuce. It might be gray, but you got a head full of hair.
Yeah, I didn't know that. I was wondering where you were seeing it. You know, it has evolved. Okay, I've got that. I think it's evolved. You know, where you just listen to his announcements, right? You know, right there. You look at the NFL players on teams. You look at you know, the quarterback from Commerce 2 years ago, Luis Perez, that won the Harlan Hill. You know, it continues to attract a high caliber athlete. And you're exactly right. There's nothing D2 about this conference. They're attracting Division I athletes. And you know, you look and you listen to these coaches. They're graduating them. They're playing competitive football. You know, it's a lot of fun. You know, I went and got my old conference championship ring from when I was a player at Southwest Texas that is now Texas State. And, you know, you look at it and, you know, you have those goals here. I remember when I first got my first ring and how proud I was to get a conference ring. And you look back at it and you reminisce. And I know how these guys, you know, feel when they get the rings. We actually talked about it driving over here today. But, you know, like I said, I get out of bed every morning, 3-point stance. Wife says, set hut. I go to work and can't imagine doing anything else.
Somehow I totally believe that, too. He really does. Amon, I want to begin with you. First of all, I see you're actually wearing the bling. Oh, you both are wearing the bling. Okay. So here's the thing. As he mentioned, he walks into a successful program, and you guys are fresh off a national championship 2 years ago. Having tasted that and seen the top, how has that changed your motivation moving forward?
I mean, we see what it takes to get there. So, I mean, everybody's bought in. Everybody knows we have to work to get to that point. So I feel like from last year to now, everybody is on the same page. I would say I don't feel like everybody was on the same page last year, which our record speaks for it. So, I mean.
How have you seen I don't know. He and Colby are seeming more alike. The more I get to talk to him here, he and Colby are a lot alike. But what maybe – how would you compare Coach Bailiff and Coach Carthel and the cultures that you guys have there?
I mean, they both – I think both coaches really – like, they both got a good sense of humor. For me as a player, and I know I could probably speak for most players in there, when you have a coach who acts like he wants to be there, then it makes the game so much better, you know? So me having a coach that I can go to Coach Bailiff and talk to him about anything and just joke with him and play around. You can't do that with every coach, you know? So, I mean, that's how I feel about him. He's a good dude.
Good dude. Dominique, how about you? How would you compare him, Coach Carthel, and the fact that you guys have been able to maintain that success?
Well, one thing I know, we prepare for every game like it's going to be our last game. We prepare for every game the same. And then as far as the coaches go, they're all passionate. They love the game. He wakes up in a three-point stance. I mean, that right there shows you, like, he's very passionate about the game. Coach Carthel was too, so it's very fun to be around.
How would you describe what Coach Bailiff is doing, though?
He's bringing on a new system, and we all have to buy into it. That's the thing we're most eager to do. Like, we've had new coaches and stuff, but for everybody to change, we're all eager to get out there and learn a new system and just play against everybody the exact same. Play our game.
Well, and I know you, Dominique, set the LSC record for punt returns in a season last year, where 36 plus took two of those to the house. How do you do it? The return game is something not all are cut out to be a part of. Mm-hmm. How are you able to have success there?
I got a lot of blockers, a lot of good blockers. My main job is just to catch the ball. And once I catch the ball, I look up and there's a bunch of guys, you know, riding for me every time. Bunch of blocks, alleys, any way I want to go, like, it's there for me. So I'd say my team. I mean, my team is the biggest impact for me. And I just try to play my role for it.
And I know you were just a sophomore. It's crazy to think you were just a sophomore last year. How have you grown in the last year? How have you changed as a player?
I mean, I'd say I'm becoming more of a leader. You know, last year, I mean, not last year, but I was a redshirt freshman traveling. So I got to see, like, how everything is supposed to be done. Or if I didn't like something, I get to see what I want to change. So, I mean, me saying that just made me have a better outlook, I guess, on things. I don't know. That's it.
Now, you're taking over Commerce here, and these guys are walking around with this bling. I mean, how much pressure does that put on you? If, you know, they're looking at you, Coach, like, hey, we want another.
You know what? I do, too. You know what they don't? We're going to learn, though, that if you shake his hand, it hurts him. You know, you got to wear those things.
It's hard to, like, hold your
hand, but they can't get their – actually, it's so they can't get their billfolds out of their back pocket. They've made me buy breakfast. But, no, it's got to be every coach's goal, you know, to wear it to win a ring yearly. That's the beauty of this sport is, you know, every year, regardless of what happened the last season, there's power in success, there's power in failure. And fortunately right now we've had a lot of success around there. And it's my job, and I take it very seriously, that we have to meet those expectations. And I think we will. And like I said, you win your locker room first. You win when you win your locker room. We've got a beautiful locker room. We've got a great culture. And I'm counting on these leaders to help me sustain it.
Listen, Colby said there was no better guy for the job. So welcome back to the game, and we can't wait for the season. Thanks so much for being here today, Coach. Hey, thanks, guys, so much. Let's give it up for A&M Commerce.